first world, and I hope to fight with different boxer.
My thing is being a world champion myself. I know it's important to take those fundamental steps and not rush a fighter. Like David Reed, my brother, I feel like they rushed him. He was fighting for world titles at, 12, 13 fights? You go up fast, you come down fast, you know, where he should have had more longevity.
Well,
you know?
Promoters and managers see exactly. The dollar signs, and exactly. They want to cash in, and that's where you get burnt.
Exactly, and I'm not going to let that happen to Rosvan because I believe that he has the ability to do something that other fighters cannot do, which is fight on the inside. He's fighting off angles. He's pivoting. He's kicking back. He's feinting. He's doing the things that the old fighters of all the tapes I studied from, you know, my legendary trainer, Bill Slayton, who trained Ken Norton, Michael Dokes, worked with the Corey brothers, you know, passed on to me. So I'm passing it on to him.
Did you start playing soccer as a kid or other sports? Because the movement that you have in the ring is not normal.
When I was a kid, I like to play handball, if you know.
Handball?
Yes.
Is that against the wall?
Yes, with seven, like basketball, but a little different, with a little ball.
Uh-huh. You know. And how do you play that game?
With hand, you know? Uh-huh. It's like a volley, but different with two team, with like a soccer.
Oh,
with hand.
Yeah. It's very physical. It's ugly.
Wow. No, it's not ugly.
No. I mean, like...
You must have a power in the arms.
It's big in Europe where you run and there's a goal like soccer and you throw the ball. No, I know. I'm not saying really. It's physical because you don't think that those guys hit, but they hit.
Yeah. It's hard.
Yeah, it's very popular in Europe right now.
You can receive the elbow and...
It's very popular in Germany.
Yes, in all Europe.
Yeah, because...
It's not like soccer, but it's popular.
Because in boxing, many times the big guys, and you know this, I'm not going to say they're clumsy, but they don't have that slickness, the smoothness that he has.
Right.
So you think you got it from that sport, how to maneuver and how to move? And
yes, I'm healthy. I have a healthy family. I have healthy brothers, tall like me. We are born like our tree, genealogic tree, you know, was healthy, you know, and we are not with, like you say, Ivan Drago, no? With steroids, you know, without vitamin.
He sounds like a machine, too.
I must break it.
but you're loving it, and right now, so you're fighting very soon. What is it going to take for you to win that fight?
My great French fought both of them.
I don't know. Only my strategy with my coach.
That's it.
I think it's enough.
And did your father box? Your uncle?
My father a little bit, like 2 years, 3 years, but not same. Before, you know, the boxing was very hard with little gloves, without mouthpiece.
Oh, my gosh.
But before that, they fought barefisted, right?
Yes. I now, talk about old boxing. Old school.
We all know Lucian Bute.
Yes. Sure.
Superstar from Romania. Mm-hmm. Are you going to beat him bigger and better than Lucian, you think?
I hope. I don't know. No?
Of course. Why not? Go for it. Because you're here with the best.
I respect Bute, Lucian. It's a great fighter. It's a great guy. Without the TV, the show, you know. Like a man. But why not? I'm coming here to make my dream reality, you know? For that. Only for that.
How far do you see him going?
I don't think nobody gonna beat him. I mean, like I said, I think the only person that could beat him is himself. Because as long as he's not being rushed and he's been built up right, I mean, like I said, he can fight on the outside like Vladimir. He can fight on the inside like Lamar Brewster. Who can beat that?
You can, not when you're 6'7".
I wouldn't want to fight that. I'd rather fight Vladimir because at least Vladimir can fight on the inside. I don't want to fight with nobody that big, punch that hard, that can fight on the inside.
And that's one advantage the Klitschko's have because they're so big.
Yeah.
Whether you're Thomas Adamack, whether you're Chris Arreola, they just couldn't get in there.
Right.
But if he's 6'7", that levels the playing field.
Exactly. And, you know, I think like with time, just how they added the cruiserweight division, I wouldn't be surprised because, you know, people continue to evolve with evolution and they're getting bigger and bigger and bigger. I wouldn't be surprised if they didn't have a cutoff weight limit, you know, where, you know, maybe 245 or 250, then you're in a super heavyweight division because, you know, when you take a guy that's a great fighter at 215, he just he just don't have what it takes to be able to fight a guy 297 feet tall. You know, it just, you just can't, you know, and that's why they created the cruiserweight division. But I don't know, maybe I'm just spinning my wheels. Maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. I don't know. We'll see. Time tells all.
We'll see what happens. Last thing, so yeah. What was your secret? Well, how tall are you?
I'm 6'1 and a half.
Okay. Vladimir is how tall?
6'7.
How were you able to do something that nobody, almost nobody has done? How were you able to get in there and knock him out?
Because I understood that if I made Vladimir go to a point where it wasn't about how good he was, it wasn't about how hard he could punch, it wasn't about his gold medal, it wasn't about his height, but when it, if I, what I'm trying to say is I made him get to the point where he had to fight me on pure will, pure heart. And then it came a matter of who heart was the biggest. Well, obviously mine was bigger. I mean, you know, you can run, you can box, you can do it all, but when you get tired and you still got to fight, do you still want to be in there? He didn't. I told him he had to kill me to beat me.
Everybody says that, but nobody does it.
Well, I proved it. I proved it time and time again. You know, I mean, my thing is pressure busts pipes.
That's true.
So I busted his pipe, and I busted a whole lot of others.
There you have it. Stay tuned for more from the IFC Gym in Van Nuys. FegasNewsReporting.com. Melly Stack back reporting.